Welcome in, everybody. It's time for another week of Angry Birds Friends. I think the bunny business is over. It was kind of fun, though. I was doing good on Sunday or Monday thing, but today's Thursday. It's week 257A, and let's click play and find out what we did. Wow, that's a big drop. I was at number 4 or number 3 the last time I checked. So, well, let's go back. Oh, Chuck and the score. Chuck gives you 1.5 times more score in this tournament. Oh, that's great. So you want to do a lot of damage with Chuck, because if, let's say there's 5,000 points in front of you, then he's going to give you 7,500, basically. That's nice. It's an extra 50%, basically. All right. Oh, it says 1.5 more. Okay, well, anyway. So we want to make sure that we do play it. Let's go to spin. Come on, big money, big money, big money, big money. Whoop! Actually got big money. Oh, let's go to the shopping cart and do power-ups, and then we're going to get this thing started. Okay, power-ups are done. Let's go back and get into this. So this is just a weekly tournament, but again, Chuck is giving you 1.5 times more score. So we're going to do as much damage with Chuck as we can. So let's go to level 1 and get to it. Oh, wow. Chuck red, Chuck red, Chuck red, Chuck red. But you know what? I feel like let's start with a Birdquake on this one. Okay, well, or maybe not. You'd think it would do something, but... Now, I'm going Wishbone on this. You can use the Jingle Sling, but because there are some concrete things that are holding this up, sometimes you need that little bit of extra power, so I'm going to actually start above. Because sometimes it'll, you know, if you start above and things fall, it'll get rid of the other stuff. Now, here's what's interesting. What we could do is switch to the Jingle Sling and go right in here. There we go. And those ornaments on there... this thing's going to bounce forever. The ornaments on there will actually kind of help break through that concrete. Now, see, this is a nice cascade effect here. One thing starts to affect another. That's what I like happening. It doesn't always happen, but... Now, this guy up here by himself with the yellow balloon, I'm going to wait and see if I can get that with a red. I'm going to use Chuck and go into this other apparatus... to Jingle Sling. You don't have to go back and forth like this. I'm just trying to make the most... Oh, there we go. Just trying to make the most of it here. You know, the only thing that stinks is these ornaments don't bounce necessarily. I mean, we got all the pigs. So... We could just kind of leave this where it's at, because this guy, if he kept bouncing up and down, he would probably gain enough momentum that he would hit the red and blue, the one on the left there, the balloons. But it looks like he's just going back and forth. So let's go ahead and end this and go to level 2. Ferris wheel. Oh my goodness, there are all kinds of triggers here too. I kind of want... Let's use a scope for this because we really want to stay on cue, but I wonder what happens if we go right here. Okay, well that happens. All right. So there are all kinds of... Holy smokes, ignition switches. I don't really know where to go with this though. mean, what do you do? Oh, wait a minute. Let's try something. Doesn't mean it's going to work. But if we go here and try to inch in right there. I mean, not what I planned, but certainly an interesting take on everything. Oh, wow, we've only got one bird left. I mean, we could go right here, but man, let me go up and over. Kind of like this, bring him back down. Maybe a little too soon. Okay, well, that didn't work. Let's try a bird quake, though. Now see, this is interesting because it's still not getting everything. When you hit ignition switches, I think it lets go of that. The TNT is released and it kind of just goes wherever. I'm just gonna, you don't always have to use HAL as a ricochet. See, when that ignition happened, the other one flew off, so I don't know. We got a lot of stuff here, though. You could use a wingman and wipe out these diamonds on the right to get a higher score. I mean, so far, we're doing okay, but I don't want to press my luck too much. Okay, so we have Chuck Bomb, Chuck Bomb. I really kind of want to go right down in here. Nope, that's not going to do it, though. See, there's a little thing of dynamite right in here. If I could just get to that. See, that's not doing it, though. Let me come up over here. Let's try this. Let's get rid of this guy. Come in here. Now let's just go right in here. There is a little pig in here and some TNT. Okay, so we can blow that out. Now we've got a pig sitting over here, and really the only thing holding up this pig on the right is that dang balloon. Now, I don't know if there's really a way to... I mean, you could use a sling and try to come in with this bomb and get all of this glass. Actually, you don't even need the scope if you do it right. And make some more points, but whoever has scored ahead of me... I mean, they're 50,000 points ahead of me, so they figured something out here. Okay, this looks easy as heck, doesn't it? Like, this isn't even hard. You can wingman your way right through this. But here's the downfall, though. You wingman your way through something, wipe everything out, but you're not getting the 1.5 times points with Chuck because you're going to bypass all of it. Why would you need him at that point, right? But I am going to use Terrence here and go right in here and see how much damage I can do here. He didn't get the last pig, but I am going to use Chuck and just clobber all of this. Okay, if we go in, boy, we had one like this before. I'm just trying to figure out what it did. And I know that there's a way to... There we go. I know there's a way to do this with the wingman and kind of sweep back under everything and get it. I want to try this again. Because I think what's going to happen, remember the podium that the thing, that the sling is setting on will bounce back as well. So I could go rubber sling and take myself right here and see what happens. You know, that's not bad, but it's not really what I wanted either. Dang it. Now let's go over the top and get this stuff. Well, I was hoping those ornaments were going to hit this guy hanging here. Now I've got myself in a noodle because I can't get rid of this guy now. Like, now I'm stuck. Good grief. But I am gonna do this again. Okay, so instead of using the bouncy, or maybe I should just go in lower with that though. Like maybe I should go in here. Because I'm hitting this brick stuff or this concrete that's hanging. That's what slowed me down. If I go in here, though, let's try this. Okay, so let's go up top here. And there we go. So, you know, now with Chuck, what do you do? Do you just take the points? Because are you going to get 10,000 points or not just going through this wood? I'm going to give it a try because I'm already not ahead of my other scores. So. Well, you know, look, portals. You do what you can. Let's get a couple of these guys on standby here. All right, so we just got Chuck, Matilda, and Terrence here. I'm gonna do these two in case I need it, but let's do a birdquake first. I kind of have an idea here. Let's see what happens. The options are you can go up into this portal and it will come out down here, hit this guy, all this will collapse. You can also send something down here like a wingman. He's gonna come out this portal and, oh, well, you know what? Let's do that. No, because you want, let's do this first. See, what I'm thinking is, instead of going into this other portal and taking a chance, I think what you should do is go right here and nail through this stuff. See, that just demolished everything right there, didn't it? So, but you still have an option. There are three diamonds here and three here. I'm going to go over here. This seems safer. Hopefully. There you go. Oh, and we're still coming back and getting a couple more. Excellent. Oh, he's got... Uh-oh. So we didn't do so bad on that last one. You really don't, the portals, you know, are there. They can be helpful, but sometimes they're not. I'm leaving this right where it's at because I'm not stupid. I know when to end it when it's ahead. But some of these are, you know, this one, it's gonna be a little tricky. So there may be a couple of ways to get through that. So if you have some wingman, give it a try. Look, I'm number two in the tournament, but I don't think that's gonna last very long. But I kinda like this week, so we'll see how it happens. Give the video a thumbs up, click the like button, it helps. Click subscribe so you don't miss it. We have a cooking show every Friday at 5 p.m., a vlog every Tuesday at 5 p.m., times are Eastern. And of course, every Monday and Thursday, there are Angry Birds videos. Plus, if there's more than it says it calls for, like with the Easter tournament, we did three over a weekend because there were three tournaments. So this is week 257A. Thank you for watching. Have a great weekend, and I'll see you on Monday, if not before. Bye.